Now, I said it earlier that I try to think of these categories as not lockstep, necessarily progressive categories. I do think this I am may be the apex, though. I also think we will probably not meet very many I am people. Most all of us are going to be on the way toward. There was Paul who dared say, I am a man in Christ. He is also the one to the Philippians said, if you want to know what this looks like, how do you live this life? Imitate me. I also heard one interpreter say, surely Paul was from somewhere in Texas. Nobody else would brag like that. But you get it? There is a self-confidence that comes with it. And so, those who come to more and more, they begin to express the very nature of God. And as God would provide for people's needs, they're hungering and they're thirsting at all levels of human existence. These I am people are going to be about that. It is God's work. So there you have it, my five-pronged approach to get at the Bible and using hunger as the driving issue. It does have some overlap with Long and Gustafson. You heard some classical ethical theory, deontological, duty, teleological, consequential, casting out there, and certainly the relational theory, relating to one another. And it looks like it keeps pressing us, become more and more one who sees and deals with hunger. It may be that the Bible, why the Bible and hunger still remains as a question. Well, Stanley Grintz, in his Theology for the Community of God, said, the Spirit gave us the Bible through inspiration and for illumination. If you didn't hear anything else I said, you can put those two words alongside. Scripture can inspire us with regard to hunger in this world. It can illuminate our hearts and minds. Now, I'm going to add two more terms to Grintz's tags. He said inspiration and illumination. I'm going to add integration and implementation. For bringing to bear Scripture on life, we can find integration of our own selves. Lady that I responded to her letter when I worked in Nashville. We had begun a huge campaign in the SBC to deal with hunger, world hunger. And she wrote in basically thanking the SBC and anybody that would answer. She said, finally, somebody has given me something by which I can live out my faith. That I am on the right track. Faith, belief in Scripture, living life, feeding the hungry. They're one and the same. Well, Kathleen Norris said it like this in her Acedia and Me. She strikes against the compartmentalization that has come in to the practice of Christian life. I alluded to it earlier. But breaking down, separating, keeping apart, spiritual formation, ethics, and evangelism. It's not a dichotomy. It's a trichotomy. And we've done pretty well at making it happen. But these matters are necessary for each other. There's need for balance. If we start with one part, we should be going and including the other. She said, and she maintained, everyday life holds the seeds of salvation. He said, the most important thing I can be doing is to care for others. So in short, extending literal food to another in the name of Jesus demonstrates we have an extraordinary understanding of God's message to humanity, of how we should be related to one another and how we should be related to God. Nothing can be so authenticated to ourselves, to others, as to what it means to live God.